Hello all you Sawyer Knights out there. For today's video, I am going to do something a little different. This is going to be a segment called Tales from the Sawyerverse. And it's going to be basically me telling you stories about how I used to come up with characters when I was a kid. You know, we've all done it. You know, all of us kids have done comic book stories. We've made up our own characters, our own villains, our own fights and stuff. I went pretty far with it when I was a kid. I used to come up with my own publication company and my own publication history. I used to come up with these fake writers and artists that would have different runs on the character. I was like so into it. Like I really created so much of a world with this. And you know, as a kid, I didn't really was not very good at writing, physically writing or drawing at all. So I used to just come up with these characters and stories, but I wouldn't really write them down that much. So some of it has kind of lost its way, has been lost in translation over the years. But the majority of it's still in my head, and I'm at a point now where, you know, I don't really necessarily, it would be cool to, like, have some of this stuff come to life in comic book or form or some kind of form, but I'm not really that worried about it. I really just want to more share it with people and see what people's responses are to what these stories are like. So for today's segment, I'm going to do one of my favorite ones, one of the ones I think is a bit more edgy and more original out of all the ones I've come up with, and that's a character called Spectrum. So, essentially, Spectrum is a story of an older legacy hero, you know, called Spectrum, who was basically this, you know, big fighter back in the good old days, and he had a long history of villains and battles and saving the day, and he has a kid and a wife, and Spectrum's costume is pretty much, in my mind, I never drew it or anything, but in my mind, I always kind of thought of it as a very much a Spider-Man-like costume with full mask, full bodysuit. But more of a Captain America color scheme, like white and blue. Not necessarily patriotic, but just a color scheme of blue and white with maybe a little red in there. So basically the idea of Spectrum is that one day the kid and the mom are having breakfast in the morning, and dad's been out all night. The mom thinks that he's like cheating on her and all that. He barges in the room all in his costume. They didn't know who he was before this. He barges in the room in his costume. He's all bloody and beaten. And from that point on, it becomes this whole family dynamic where they all know who he is, but the wife can't handle it. She can't handle being married to a vigilante crime fighter that might end up dead one day. So she runs out on him and leaves, and the boy basically has to kind of, you know, he has to become a man a lot quicker than he would normally, you know, basically having to fix up his dad. I was thinking kind of like looking back at it, it's kind of like a Daredevil vibe with Matt Murdock having to stitch up his dad, be a cut man for him. And so, as the years go on, the son kind of, he starts rebelling, because that's what kids do, they rebel. And he starts getting into bad habits and being pushed away from his dad, or pushing his dad away. And so eventually when he's older, about 19, 20 years old, something like that, he ends up joining like a local gang of like some punks. And one day they're out, robbing a store or something, and the lights go out, and they start getting picked off one by one by somebody, and, the kid, who I never actually came up with a name for, but let's just call him Jason for right now. So Jason, he's basically, like, worried and scared and doesn't know what's going on. He's high on something. I never really got into details on what kind of drugs he takes, because I'm not really a drug person. But he pulls out his gun, and, like, he shoots the person that's coming at him, because the person hesitates for some reason. The lights come back on. He realizes that he just shot his dad. He just killed his dad. He just killed a national superhero. And that's like the first issue. That's pretty much the catalyst for what the story is. It's a redemption story. It's a legacy story about this son who basically kills his dad. He ends the legacy right there. And then he has to basically, in the series, he basically ends up redeeming himself eventually and has to take the costume on and become a hero. Because what happens is he gets sent to a prison where all his dad's big villains are. And some of them they want to beat him up, they want to kill him, whatever. But the big dog at the prison, the one that like basically runs all the inmates, he's basically Spectrum's greatest villain from back in the day, is a guy called Buzzsaw, who was, basically like this kind of not really mad scientist, but this really clever engineer guy that was really good with his hands. He made all kinds of saw weapons. He had like saw blades that shot out of his hands, and he used like these hidden saw blades he could come out with and cut you up with. Kind of a Wolverine kind of character, a little bit of inspiration there. Kind of like Wolverine meets the cleverness of the Joker without the crazy of the Joker, if that makes any sense. So Buzzsaw, you know, he's happy for Jason. He keeps taunting Jason by saying stuff like, "Oh, this guy's a national hero. He should be our greatest hero. He killed our enemy or whatever, you know, stuff like that." And basically just keeps him alive, basically just to torture with him, you know. And so what ends up happening is Jason's put on death row, and he's about to be executed whenever his inherited powers from his dad are passed on to him. And basically he uses the powers to break out of the chair and escape the prison. But in doing so, he makes a big hole in the prison wall, which a lot of the villains are able to escape from. And he basically causes yet another big issue where all of his dad's old villains are out in the open trying to take over the city or do whatever. And that's basically where the bulk of the first few storylines come from, is basically Spectrum. He puts on his dad's old costume. He has to go out and try to stop these criminals and stuff that are out there because of him. And eventually he kind of becomes this hero, but he's a very reluctant hero, kind of a rugged, you know, hero. Very much kind of more of an anti-hero than anything. And, it was a series that I thought would be really interesting to see. You know, you don't really see that too often. You don't see a hero that literally kills a hero and takes over the mantle. It's really interesting to me. Some of the other villains that he frees, there's a guy called, I never came up with a name for him, but he's like this former KGB operative that has, like, he's a spy, kind of assassin character anything he touches he can camouflage with and blend in with. So I always thought that was a kind of a cool power. Another guy who's basically just a super strong bruiser kind of villain, pretty generic villain honestly. And then he had a couple other guys, nothing too special. But you know, that was basically the bulk of the first storyline, was that, you know, he's basically taking these criminals down one by one as they're trying to join forces, and Buzzsaw is the final guy he has to take down at the end of the storyline. So yeah, and I have a lot more of these if you guys are interested. If you guys are interested in these kind of like basically just pitches or, you know, fictional stories that I've come up with, let me know, and I'll definitely put out more volumes going over some of the other characters I have. Like I said, I have hundreds of these characters that I've come up with over the years. So yeah, just let me know. And as always, like, comment, subscribe.